Okay, buenos días otra vez. Vamos a continuar con el vocabulario de capítulo 2. Vamos a hablar de la hora. Okay, so la hora means the hour. And we're talking about time telling in Spanish. So first of all, ¿qué hora es? Is how we ask, what time is it? ¿Qué hora es? And there is another question. ¿A qué hora es? And then fill in the blank here. I'm going to underline it. So if you want to ask what time something is, ¿a qué hora es la clase de español? ¿A qué hora es la fiesta? ¿A qué hora es la película? Película is a movie. So at what time is? So a difference between those questions. This one is simply what time is it right now? A qué hora is at what time is something. Okay. Very important to know the distinction between the two questions. Now, the next thing is if it is 1 o'clock, then you're going to use the verb es. And if it's anything with 1 o'clock, so if it's 1 and 15 minutes, 1 and 30 minutes, 1 and 45 minutes, even up to 1 and 59 minutes, you're going to use es. So es la una, and right over here is how you're going to say quarter after. So you could say es la una y cuarto. If it is 1:30, es la una y media, and so on. Okay. However, if it's 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, then you're going to use son. Son las dos, son las tres, son las cuatro, son las seis, son las siete, son las ocho y cuarto, son las nueve y media, etcétera, etcétera. Okay. So next, two expressions that are good to know. Es el mediodía. It is noon. That translates literally middle of the day. Es la medianoche. It's midnight, middle of the night. And then this next sentence is like I was talking about because one is involved. Es la una y diez. So that means it's 1:10. Son las dos y cinco. It's 2:05. Son las cinco menos veinte. Okay, now here is where we start getting into something different too. In Spanish, once you get past that half hour, instead of continuing to add minutes on, you subtract from the next hour up. So this is literally saying it is 5 o'clock minus 20. This would be great for my husband. He doesn't speak Spanish, but he'll always say, "Oh, it's almost 5 o'clock and it's only 4:35." And I'm like, "No, we have 25 minutes yet before it's 5 o'clock." So that tendency to round up is here in the Spanish language. While you could say, "Son las cuatro y cuarenta." It doesn't sound like a native speaker. It sounds much more native to say, son las cinco menos veinte. Got that? So this time we would write with a digital clock as 4:40. Okay. Son las tres y media. It is 3:30. Son las cuatro y cuarto. That is 4:15. Son las seis menos cuarto. That is 6 minus 15 minutes. So, in other words, 5:45. And I'm going to write these there. So, this is cuatro y cuarto, just so you have that digital clock to help you. So, y cuarto is plus 15, y media is plus 30. Menos cuarto is minus 15. Note that we don't say menos media. So I don't have it written. Okay. One more thing to take on to your time telling as you're telling time. De la mañana, This is morning, so this is like from 6 a.m. until we'll say noon. And then de la noche, so we'll say that this is from 6 p.m. until midnight. De la tarde is the afternoon, so from noon until 6 p.m. Oops. And de la madrugada, this is the wee hours of the morning. So this is from midnight until 6 a.m. So that is something that we put on the end of our sentence. Let me give you an example. I'm going to stick a new text box in here. And suppose I want to say that it is 2:15 in the morning. Son las dos de la madrugada. I don't know why anyone would be up at that time. Let's say that I just want to say it's 10 in the morning, so middle of a school day. Son las 10 de la, and I'm going to copy this because then I get the tilde without having to do an insert. I bet it's going to be bigger. No, it's the same size. Good. Son las 10 de la mañana. It's 10 in the morning. If I want to say it is 3:15 in the afternoon, son las tres, oops, tres y cuarto de la tarde. So it's 3:15 in the afternoon. And let's say I want to say it's 7:30 at night. Son las siete y media de la noche. There, I think I used an example of each of those little prepositional phrases. Okay, so that helps to explain what time it is. All right, moving on to preguntas, questions. So some of the questions that we'll be practicing in class with this chapter will be to continue to describe people since we've got lots of adjectives. ¿Cómo son los alumnos? What are the students like? Los alumnos son muy inteligentes. Notice my adjective agreed. It was plural because los alumnos is plural. Los alumnos son muy guapos. We can say we have good-looking students. Los alumnos son muy altos. We can say that they're all very tall. Los alumnos no son perezosos. They are not lazy. Okay. ¿Cómo es la profesora? What's the teacher like? La profesora es muy baja. The teacher is very short. La profesora es muy inteligente. The teacher is very intelligent, and so on. ¿Quién es la profesora? So if you wanted to ask your friend who they have as a teacher for a certain class, ¿Quién es la profesora de la clase de historia? Because we have some different teachers. We have more than one. Except we wouldn't say la profesora. ¿Quién es el profesor de la clase de historia? El profesor es señor Oliver. Okay. ¿De dónde es el profesor? From where is the teacher? El profesor es de. I'm trying to think if I know where any of our teachers are originally from. I'm not sure I could answer that. I think that Senor Zeta is de Grafton. I think Mr. Z is from Grafton. ¿Qué clase? Ooh, I have another typo. ¿Qué clase es? If you want to ask, oh, what class is this? Like you pop your head in some door and you're wondering what class they're working on. ¿Qué clase es? ¿Cuántos alumnos hay en la clase? That's asking how many students are there in the class. En nuestra clase de español, de la clase A, hay 14 estudiantes, creo. I think that class has 14. I'm trying to remember. Y la clase C tiene 19 estudiantes. The other one has 19 students. ¿Quiénes son? Who are they? So then you could list them off. Couple important things. C is yes, has an accent. C without an accent is if. And when you answer, often you will use a no, no, when it's a double negative, when you're answering